ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فهو المهتد ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، أرسل رسوله بالهدى ودين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله ولو كره المشركون. اللهم صلِّ وسلِّم وبارِك على سيدنا ونبينا وحبيبنا وقائدنا ومرشدنا وحجتنا وشفيعنا محمد، وعلى آله الطيبين الطاهرين وصحبه أجمعين ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كلام الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة. عباد الله، أوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله وطاعته، وأحثكم على التمسك بهدي قرآنه وسنة نبيه، فقد قال الله جل من قائل بعد: أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا، يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. صدق الله العظيم. My dear sisters and brothers, last week's khutbah was intended to be the introduction to the topic I want to talk about today. And unfortunately, and I say unfortunately, it has become a seasonal topic. Not that we lack the ability to understand all its ramifications and what it really means and entails, but because we have the tendency to always stir the dust in the pot of water that we have. We always like to dissociate. And I mentioned last week how bad in the eyes of Allah it is for us to consider things that are not part of the usul, that are not part of the core system of our deen, to use them as means to develop disagreement that leads to enmity. This is not our deen. Our deen, as I mentioned last week, tells us, وَاعْتَصِمُوا بِحَبْلِ اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا وَلَا تَفَرَّقُوا. Hold on to the rope of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and do not dissociate. And the topic of contention, the topic of disagreement, you guessed it, is some people make it at the level of haram to even think of celebrating the birth of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Others encourage that we should celebrate the birth of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And I some time ago mentioned that the problem among all of us is the use of the word Eid, to use it as a wide brush to call every occasion by the word Eid. Now, there are two Eids in Islam that are ta'abbudi. Nobody disagrees on that. And when we say ta'abbudi, they are acts of worship. We've got to recognize them. We cannot fast on the day of Eid. We have salat that we have to perform. There are certain etiquettes associated with that, and they are called Eid al-Fitr and Eid al-Adha. Nobody has any problem in calling them Eid. The problem comes when people have a problem when you put the word Eid with an occasion, with an anniversary, with an event, with a historical occurrence that they call Eid. Because in the language of Arabs, the word Eid implies happiness. And when people show happiness on certain occasions, they call them Eid. But some people have problem with that. But I say linguistically, you know, Arabs use always on their cards that they exchange, they say, جَعَلَ اللَّهُ أَيَّامَكُمْ كُلَّهَا أَعْيَادٍ. May Allah make all your days Eid. Now, people who have a problem calling it Eid al-Mawlid, they don't have a problem with that phrase, with that sentence, جَعَلَ اللَّهُ أَيَّامَكُمْ كُلَّهَا أَعْيَادٍ. May Allah make all your days as Eid days. So I'm going to come to a compromise, and let's call it the anniversary of the birth of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Is there any problem? There's no problem with that, because nobody can ignore a historical event. And for some reason, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made the bi'atha of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, which is the beginning, when he was 40 years of age, of the message of Islam, in the month of Rabi' al-Awwal. He made his birth in the month of Rabi' al-Awwal. He made his death in the month of Rabi' al-Awwal. He made his hijrah from Mecca to Medina in the month of Rabi' al-Awwal. He put all of them during this month, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted us to recognize that our deen needs boosters. We cannot just say that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam had his condensed message to his companions, who really had a Eid every day. They woke up in the morning and prayed Fajr behind him. They celebrated their Islam every time they sat in his halaqa. They had a reason to be happy, to the point that we read in the Quran, قُلْ بِفَضْلِ اللَّهِ وَبِرَحْمَتِهِ فَبِذَلِكَ فَلْيَفْرَحُوا. Tell them that through the favor of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His mercy, there is a reason, a good reason for people to be happy. Ibn Abbas said, بِفَضْلِ اللَّهِ وَبِرَحْمَتِهِ, and His mercy. This rahmah is Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Because in Surah Al-Anbiya, Ayah 107, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says very clearly, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ قُلْ بِفَضْلِ اللَّهِ وَبِرَحْمَتِهِ فَبِذَلِكَ فَلْيَفْرَحُوا. What's wrong when we feel happy and have an occasion to renew our commitment to our deen? Now, you know what? Even Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam needed that boost by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala retelling him the stories and the lessons from the lives of the messengers who came before him. وَكُلًّا نَقُصُّ عَلَيْكَ مِنْ أَنْبَاءِ الرُّسُلِ مَا نُثَبِّتُ بِهِ فُؤَادَكَ. You need that, O Muhammad. We are going to tell you the stories of Nuh and Ibrahim and Musa and Isa and Salih and Hud and all of them. Why? Not to entertain you. مَا نُثَبِّتُ بِهِ فُؤَادَكَ, so that we can make your heart firm on the basis of Iman, so that you can carry on your message. And if Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam needed that tathbeet, needed that firm base, don't we need it? Don't we need to hear the qasas of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam so that we can boost our Iman, so that we can feel strong in our Iman? Now, it is something that we cannot really debate, and I don't know why we are losing energy when the celebration of the legacy of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is taking place now rightly in certain formats that do not reflect anything which is called bid'ah. You know, the celebration is, and I'll tell you certain forms of celebration that are going right now. The people of Al-Quds are celebrating right now the birth of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when they are saying wa islama, when they are going to the streets and saying, we are not going to allow those occupiers to put our heads down. This is a true celebration of the legacy of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who did not accept for Bani Qurayza to do what they did during the time of Ghazwat al-Ahzab, when he went to Bani Qaynuqa to fight them because they made fun of a woman of the Muslims. That is a true celebration. A celebration is taking place right here in Canada. We know the caring Canadian society, and I mentioned that society that we should be very proud of. They are celebrating the legacy of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam by going out to the homeless. To the homeless, I did not say to the Muslim homeless, I say to the homeless in our city, and say, we have mittens for you, we have gloves for you, we have hats for you, we have socks for you. And that is why, might as well mention it right now, I forgot to mention it last week, that we are encouraged and asked by this caring Canadian society to go and buy a few, the same as we buy for our children, and deposit them at the center, because they will collect them today and next Jumu'ah, the 21st. This is celebration, and they will go. And obviously, that's the best da'wah. They are saying, this is the legacy of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This is how we celebrate. And here at the center, you might have noticed, I don't know if your peripheral vision allowed you to see two huge posters outside. You know, these are 2 out of 15 posters that will be put across our masjid on Sunday, and the following Sunday, and the following Sunday, where inshallah, I will be celebrating with you the legacy of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in Medina. They are pictures depicting the life of our Prophet in beautiful ways. You know, when I was showing them to someone I knew a lot about Islam, he looked at one of them and he said, wallahi, I've never put things in perspective as I am doing right now when I'm watching this poster. And this is what I put it as an amana with you, that you bring all your youth, you bring your relatives, you bring everybody who needs to know the legacy of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Outside there's a picture of Ar-Rawda Sharifa in Al-Masjid Al-Nabawi. How many know the details of what's in Ar-Rawda? We will talk about that. We will talk about all the different features in Medina, inshallah. This is how we celebrate the legacy of the birth of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So I invite you to be here on Sunday and every Sunday from there on. At 12 noon till Salat al-Dhuhr, we get a booster of Iman and feel strong about our deen. This is how we love Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala coupled our love to Allah with the love of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So he said, قُلْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهِ فَاتَّبِعُونِي يُحْبِبْكُمُ اللَّهِ in Surah Ali Imran. If you claim that you love Allah, follow Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. How do you follow someone if you don't love him? It means, if you love me, love Muhammad by following his legacy, and Allah will love you in return. And also in Surah At-Tawbah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us, قُلْ إِن كَانَ آبَاؤُكُمْ وَأَبْنَاؤُكُمْ وَإِخْوَانُكُمْ وَأَزْوَاجُكُمْ وَعَشِيرَتُكُمْ وَأَمْوَالٌ اقْتَرَفْتُمُوهَا وَتِجَارَةٌ تَخْشَوْنَ كَسَادَهَا وَمَسَاكِنُ تَرْضَوْنَهَا أحب إليكم من الله ورسوله فتربص أحب إليكم من الله ورسوله فتربصوا حتى يأتي الله بأمره والله لا يهدي القوم الفاسقين. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is putting things in perspective for us. This is a daily thing, that we show love to our parents, our children, our brothers, our sisters, our spouses. We show love for the wealth we are amassing. This is a daily thing. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us, if you show love to these things, material things and social and family things that are normal and halal, but if you love them more than you love Allah, look how he coupled that with the messenger, Allah and his messenger, then wait until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will pass his degree. Now also, Muslim reported from Abi Qatada that he said, ثَلَاثَةٌ مَنْ كُنَّ فِيهِ ثَلَاثَةٌ مَنْ كُنَّ فِيهِ وَجَدَ حَلَاوَةَ الْإِيمَانِ, that there are three things, when they are found in any person, that person will enjoy the sweet taste of faith, of Iman. And one of them, أن يكون الله ورسوله أحب إليه مما سواهما. That Allah and His Messenger would be dearer and more beloved to her or him than anyone else. This is the kind of love that we feel. You know, and alhamdulillah, we are not, again, the confusion is in the word celebrating, celebration, Eid. No, we are bringing up and raising the status of our commitment to the teacher, to the mentor who brought us the clear message of Islam from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And how do we do that? We do it by showing love to this messenger, to this human being who received the wahi. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala praised the aql of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, of the brain of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, by saying, وَمَا صَاحِبُكُمْ بِمَجْنُونَ, that your companion is not possessed, is not someone who is short on mental ability. He is solid in his mental ability. That was a praise by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also praised his fu'ad, his heart. He said, مَا كَذَبَ الْفُؤَادُ مَا رَأَى, that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his heart was clear on the night of Isra and Mi'raj with what he witnessed that night. And he praised his vision, مَا زَاغَ الْبَصَرُ وَمَا طَغَى, again in Surah An-Najm, that he did not lose perspective and he saw things very clearly. He had his manners, his morality praised by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when Allah said about him, وَإِنَّكَ لَعَلَى خُلُقٍ عَظِيمٍ, verily you have the best of manners. And his guidance to his ummah was also praised by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when he said about him, وَإِنَّكَ لَتَهْدِي إِلَى صِرَاطٍ مُسْتَقِيمٍ, verily, O Muhammad, you guide people to a straight path. This is Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam according to Allah. La ilaha illallah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also, you know, he did not only show his love to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted us to translate this love into action. And the examples I shared with you are examples of celebration of the legacy. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم فيا فوز المستغفرين. Make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He will accept our dua. Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen. الحمد لله وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومواله. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. Brothers and sisters, can you imagine Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when people came to give allegiance, you know, during Fatah Makkah, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يُبَايِعُونَكَ إِنَّمَا يُبَايِعُونَ اللَّهِ يَدُ اللَّهِ فَوْقَ أَيْدِيهِمْ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told in the Quran, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that those who are making an allegiance and putting their hands in your hand, they are doing it with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that some people, you know, find it too much to bring his legacy. You know, and the argument sometimes, I don't want to enter into a debate here, but I say it that when people say that, you know, if you only choose one day to you know, celebrate that legacy, it means the rest of the year you are not. That is not true. That is not true. Because these are ayyamullah. These are the days that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you know, when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was asked, again, it's a hadith reported through the authority of Umar ibn al-Khattab and narrated by Muslim, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he made the fasting of Monday as, a day that is recommended for us to fast. When asked about that, why, Ya Rasulullah, why Monday? He said, ذَلِكَ يَوْمٌ وُلِدْتُ فِيهِ وَبُعِثْتُ فِيهِ. Look at this. He said, it is a day wherein I was born and wherein I was sent with the message of Islam. Had his birth been a personal thing as it is for all of us, he would not have mentioned it, because Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said very clearly to his companions, "La tutruni kama atrat an-nasara Isa ibn Maryam, innama ana 'abdullah wa rasuluh." He said, "I don't want you to praise me the same as Christians praised Isa, the son of Maryam. Verily, I am only a servant of Allah and his messenger." So he does not want us to praise him. Therefore, by mentioning his birth, he did not call for us to praise his birth. But he mentioned it as, look at this, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who planned the timeline of history, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala could have made Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam being Adam, and then the entire humanity would have followed him and the Quran until the day of judgment. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose a particular date, particular day, particular month to have him born, so that it will fit into history at the right time. Therefore, the birth of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam is the birth of the final message of Islam. And you know, in the Quran, when Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam talked about the other issue, which is the bi'tha, he said, "Bu'ithtu ana was-sa'ata kahatayn," that when I was sent with the message of Islam, it was at the same time of the bi'tha of Islam. And that was 1400 years ago, which means that the birth of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was the birth of the message of Islam. So don't find it too difficult to celebrate and to enjoy and to learn and to teach. So please, I leave it with you as an amana, that inshallah, please remember on Sunday that all of you bring your non-Muslim neighbors, invite them, let them come to our home so that we can share something. It's going to be beautiful. We will have two video clips that the youth will have a lot to talk about. They will also be watching. They will listen. They will ask questions. Don't miss it. Now tomorrow, sisters, now I'm looking at you. Tomorrow at 1 o'clock is the beginning of the women's halaqa. Please tell everybody about it and come with your questions. Come, inshallah, prepared to enjoy a setting that is yours. It will be, inshallah, in the women's section of our masjid, and it will be tomorrow at 1 to 3. And for those who want to do it today, you can go to Walmart, you can go to Winners, you can go anywhere you want. Buy mittens, gloves, adult socks, hats, and come and deposit them here so that we can go out and say, this is from the Muslims to the homeless. What a beautiful da'wah, inshallah. And don't forget, still there is room to register at the Islamic school, inshallah. Our center is coming out of age and we have a lot to offer. By the way, I had a meeting with two youth leaders last Wednesday and we discussed a huge list of activities that people may have to book a certain time to find room to do what they want to do at the center. We will do it, and that is the true celebration of Milad al-Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وخطايانا وإسرافنا في أمرنا وكفر عنا سيئاتنا. اللهم أرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه وأرنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه. اللهم علمنا من ديننا ما جهلنا وذكرنا منه ما نسينا وكن معنا ولا تكن علينا. عباد الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. اذكروا الله العظيم يذكركم وادعوه يستجب لكم ولذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون. وأقم الصلاة.